guys. Welcome back to the channel. I'm Papa Tom. I am a part of Eaching's Life. You can follow our family vlog there at Eaching's Life. I think we're changing the name actually to put Cade in it. But my wife's still working on the exact logistics of that and what she wants to do with it. But on this channel, it's my dad channel, and this is where I kind of take you along with me. There's some kid things, things that dads do. You know, I work full time at a hospital. I have a side hustle, a couple of them, to try to make extra money for the family. I go to estate sales on the weekends and I buy things that I find that I can resell on eBay, and that brings me extra money. So some of my videos, I show you some of the items I found and then what I've sold them for. So if those of you think that's something you might be interested in, you can start to look for some of the same things I look for and bring a little extra money into your pocketbook. I also like to leave my kids a lesson or a something that they can look back on when watching this channel after they've grown up or as they're growing up, so they can hear what dad said and maybe understand it a little better as they get more mature. You know, I didn't really have parents that gave me those lessons. It's funny. Well, it's not funny. It's kind of sad actually, but like, I don't ever remember my dad saying, "I love you." Not one time. Now, I was adopted, but still, if you adopt a child, that's your child. My dad, I never heard him tell me I love you. I don't have one memory of him ever telling me that. And then his parents, my grandparents, the Cades, they never said I love you either. It's just the weirdest thing. And I do remember my mom telling me one time, well, the Cades, they're just not a very lovey-lovey family. They love you, but they just don't show love. They don't say love. Well, this Cade says I love you to my kids every day. This Cade tells my wife how much I love her every day. So don't be afraid to say I love you to somebody that you love. Someday you may not be able to say it and you'll wish you could have said it. So say I love you. But anyway, guys, that's not the message I was going to leave today. So first I want to get into my Bisaya word of the day. So I like to take one word a day from my wife's dialect of the Philippines, Bisaya, and try to use it throughout that day so that I can start to retain that in my head, and then it'll ring a bell when I hear it, or maybe I'll remember it when I want to use that word. So you guys can come along and learn with me. It's just one word a day. It's not that hard to do one thing, right? You can do it. Okay, so today's word is I, you know, an I. So in English, I, in Bisaya, it's pronounced mata. So let me know in the comments down below, guys, if that's not correct or if that's not Bisaya. But I think, according to the internet, mata is I. So here's a joke, all right? So you can use this joke today. And I love telling jokes. You know, what did the left eye... Rest in peace, Left Eye Lopez. Oh, anyways, shout out. What did the left eye... Oh, I'm sorry. Dang it, I'm messing up. What did the left mata say to the right mata? What did the left mata say to the right mata? Between you and me, something smells. That's the nose, right? It smells. Not like smells, but it smells. It's a good one, guys. Share that to your kids. I want to give a shout out to one of my followers that made a comment. So today's shout out goes to Kylie Burnaby from CDO. I think that means Cagayan de Oro, right? So if that's not where you're from, I apologize, but I've been to Cagayan de Oro. That's where my first wife's family lives and it's where she's from. So visited there. Nice city. Thanks for watching. We appreciate you. So today I want to leave my kids a message. All right. So when they look back on this one today, this one's about, listen, guys, and my daughter, and they already do this kind of to a degree, but I want to encourage them to continue doing it. So do things that scare you. Seriously, do things that scare you. So Eleanor Roosevelt once said, and she was the wife of President Roosevelt, do one thing every day that scares you. Okay? Do one thing every day that scares you, right? Now, that doesn't mean step in front of traffic and like jump back before the car hits you, or run, you know, try to cross train tracks with a train coming. No, that's not what that means. Try something new. Push yourself, feel your fear, and let it motivate you to be better, okay? So take a risk. You know, it's scary to... You know, it's scary to apply for a new job. It's scary to talk to that that person in school that you don't think likes you or knows you. You know, so do one thing a day that scares you, right? It'll make you a better person. That's all I got for today, guys. Thanks for watching.
Guys, there's a special birthday happening tomorrow, so I want to give a big shout out to my Francisco Flores. She's in the Philippines. Your sister Beth in Singapore told me that's your birthday tomorrow, so happy birthday, Mai. Thanks for watching.
Hey guys, so welcome back to our channel. William. So we're outside. William. We've got William, Kathleen, and Michael. William. And we're gonna play a mean game of wiffle ball. Who's gonna be the best hitter? Raise your hand. Okay, so we got two guys saying yes, and we got the silent assassin Kathleen over here going, I'm really the best one, right? So, all right, we're gonna practice catching, we're gonna practice throwing, and we're gonna practice hitting, guys. Okay.
Why are there like branches? Are there the roots?
Yeah, that was where the trees and they cut them down.
But it's so small.
Yeah, so be careful coming over here so you don't follow them. Okay, come here, guys. Let's move this big rock out of the way.
Yep.
Okay, come over here, guys. Okay. So first, let's put the bat down. We're going to practice with the glove how to catch. So you get the big glove, okay? You do. You're going to... Okay. So you're going to put your hand in your left hand.
Okay.
And you can squeeze it. See how you squeeze it? Let me show Kathleen. See how you squeeze it? Where's your thumb
at? I know how to squeeze it, Daddy.
Okay. Yeah. You can practice putting your hand in there. Just, no, it's got this hand.
I did this.
Yeah, because you're going to throw with your right hand.
I did it like
Which
this.
Hand do you throw with? Which hand do you throw with?
All of
them. Do you throw with that hand?
Daddy!
Yeah, so that hand
Daddy.
Just catches. Okay, so where's your... Let me see. Take your hand out real quick.
Daddy!
Hold on, buddy.
Look, what the heck?
Oh, that's just the glove. We have to wash our hands.
Glove.
Okay. So put your hand in there and put your... So you're going to put your hand in so your thumbs... All you're going
to
really do is just squeeze it. So put that hand in. And try to squeeze it up there as far as it'll... Can you feel? See how there's different
so
fingers?
So the hedgehogs!
Okay.
I want to go on the
open
base.
Your hand up like this.
Now
squeeze
base?
Your thumb. Yes, that's perfect. See, you're gonna. What's gonna happen is, if the ball comes, you put this hand out, and you can catch the ball, and you can squeeze your thumbs to hold the ball, right?
And then you'll get the
so that's how you catch.
I got the.
Okay.
I got the ball.
Let me see if yours on the wrong hand, buddy. Your glove goes on this hand. Put all your fingers up in there. Now squeeze your hand so you can close it like this. Right.
Uncle Tom, can you try doing that?
Yeah, I'm gonna have you guys all three stand there. We're gonna practice catching. Okay, come here, Michael. So, Kathleen, you stand there.
Thank you.
I'm gonna show you how to swing the bat first. Okay? So you guys stand there. So you're gonna have your right arm up. Okay? And keep the bat kind of like back. But see, you gotta have good balance. Right? So when the ball's coming, watch what I do with my feet. I'm gonna shift my weight. Okay? Watch this. See my back foot? You can raise your front leg. Okay? But you're gonna stand on your back leg here. Right? When the ball's coming, the bat's back here. Wait for the ball to come and then watch the ball. And then step forward and swing the bat.
Okay, I'm gonna try.
Here, I'm gonna show you. William, pitch one ball. Easy, just underhand. Okay. Pitch it right here. Oh, I missed.
You're too close now.
Toss it underhand.
Uncle Tom.
Underhand.
Me.
Yeah.
Me, Uncle Tom.
Like this.
Me. Whoa! Whoa.
Okay, underhand. Easy. Toss it up like that. Yeah.
I want to try first.
Okay, let Kathleen one pitch, and then we're going to let you guys hit and pitch. Oh, throw it again. Okay, so you're up, buddy.
And swing at it, okay? Oh, look at that. One hit right to Kathleen. And then just throw the ball back to me on the ground. There you go. Okay, ready? Here we go, guys. Bases are loaded. There's two outs in the bottom of the ninth. Michael's at the plate. Kathleen looks serious in the outfield. Here comes the pitch. Here comes the windup. Oops, strike one.
Bulldozer's up, guys. We hear that he is a talented hitter, but he's trying to hide how good he really is. Okay, you guys ready?
Did it go far, Mike?
Really good shot. I got that on tape. Maybe the scouts will see it and they'll offer you a scholarship. I mean, they want to pay you to be a professional.
You bomb!
Okay, you ready, Bomber?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, wait for the ball. Ready? Oh, that's a good hit. Hey, ready? Wait for the ball. That's okay. You're swinging good. Oh, good. That's a foul tip. That's okay. Ready? Ooh, gotta swing harder. Swing all the way through. Ready? That's okay.
Thank you.
catch it?
Me.
Okay, it's gonna go high and far.
Let me show you. So you're gonna, this is the base, okay? Here, let me stand there. So you want your feet facing that way. But turn that one so it's straight like this. Yeah, like that. But scoot back a little bit, you're a little close. Your thumb does? Okay. So now that your feet are like that, hold the bat like this, hold it up. Because you want to swing like, you want the bat to come across like this. See, look. Because the ball is going to come and you want to hit the ball with it. And then the ball will go flying. And you'll be a home run hitter. Yeah.
Sky. Okay? That's okay. You can use your hands. The ball won't hurt like this. Okay, practice catching with your hands. Close. Okay, ready, Kathleen? First shot for Kathleen. And it's a hit!
Kathleen!
Who's gonna get it? No, no, here, give me the ball. Okay,
Daddy,
ready?
Daddy, I
wanna
do two!
Well, that's okay.
I
wanna
do two.
You just did, buddy, you gotta wait.
Daddy!
Here, you and Michael play catch and practice throwing and catching. Well, I let her practice hitting. Okay, ready? Oh, good hit. No, we're gonna hit first. You ready to catch the ball? Okay, it's two outs in the bottom of the ninth. The most feared hitter in the whole land of Florida is up to bat. Her name is Kathleen the Killer. She's gonna go deep. Michael says, I don't fear her, I will sit down. I don't think she can get it past my head. Ready? Oh my gosh, right over their head. Run, run, run! There's the bag. Go to sec, Kate, right here. Oh, I dropped the ball. I'm gonna get her. Oh, she's safe.
Thank you.
Kathleen, are you ready?
Yes.
Okay. William, move, you're gonna get hit. Stand over there so you can catch it. Okay, here comes the power. We have a power slugger up. Oh, Michael can't get there. It's over his head. She's rounding first. Okay, ready? Oh, we've got a ball player, guys. Right here, this one got some skill. So all you Division I softball coaches that are watching, tell them how old you are.
11.
She's 11 years old, so she's a prodigy, guys. You can sign her early if you want to offer her a scholarship to your college. Kathleen Ahern, remember that name. Okay, ready?
I'm a good fetcher.
You're a good fetcher.